In the previous video, I explained that continuous collision detection can be used to detect collision between a fast-moving object and a static collider. And static colliders are those colliders which do not have a rigid body component attached. But what if I attach a rigid body component to the ground and turn on its kinematics so it doesn't fall? Now, this cube will fall down at a very fast speed because I have increased the value of gravity. Now, you will also notice that collision detection method is currently set to continuous. I'm going to hit on the play button. You will notice that the cube fell through the ground. This is because continuous collision detection only detects collision between an object and a static collider. Currently, the ground is a dynamic collider. To solve this issue, you can use continuous dynamic. Continuous dynamic can use to detect collision between both static colliders as well as dynamic colliders. Dynamic colliders are those colliders which have a rigid body component attached. So, currently you will notice the ground is dynamic, and I'm going to hit on the play button. You will notice that the collision occurred. It can also be used to detect collision between any fast moving object and a static collider. So if I remove the rigid body and hit on the play button again, you will notice that currently it's set to continuous dynamic and the collision still occurs. Now if you're wondering why to ever use continuous if continuous dynamic can detect both static and dynamic colliders, I'll be explaining them in the future video, so stay tuned. Also, continuous dynamic internally uses continuous. So we can say that continuous dynamic works in the same way which I explained in the previous video. So in simple words, continuous dynamic is a modified version of continuous.